Hello students, welcome back to the biology class. So in the last class, I started the new topic of lipids. I hope many of the things would be clear to you. So let me summarize the whole thing which we learned in the last class, a small recap of everything. We learned that lipids are non-polar in nature. If you remember, I gave you the explanation of that organic analysis topic also, that whenever lipids will come, they will not come in the acid soluble fraction but in the acid insoluble fraction. Reason is same, because lipids are non-polar in nature. So though they are microbiomolecules, they will come along with the macromolecules and they will be inside that acid insoluble fraction. So remember, they are non-polar, so they don't dissolve into water. But please remember that when you learn fatty acid, I explained that there are two heads present in it, two portions present in it. Head portion is hydrophilic, but the tail region is hydrophobic in nature. We learned that it is insoluble in water because it carries a long chain, and that chain is a hydrophobic chain of hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon means catenation, CHO, these things in the last class I told. Now, because it carries CHO, so it gives energy to us in oxidation. And please remember that oxygen, because more oxygen is required for the burning of the fats, that's why fats or lipids give us more energy when compared with the carbohydrate. Fats are, in chemistry, fats can even be called as fatty acids can even be called as monocarboxylic organic acid. That means it's a long chain of hydrocarbon attached with COOH. That is represented as RCOOH. And in the last class I told you the number of C generally varies from 4 to 19 in number in this case. Now the next thing which I told was that when you draw a cartoonic sketch of the fatty acid, we always represent the head portion as a round one, and that is the polar head. It is the carboxylic acid or carboxylate group, and the tail at the back side is always drawn either in a straight manner or in a zigzag manner. So the straight manner is because of the saturated fatty acid, which does not carry any double bond, because saturated fatty acids carry only the single bonds. So it is responsible for no bends, but bends will develop whenever there is a double bond in the unsaturated fatty acid. So the long hydrocarbon chain is drawn in the form of a straight line for saturated and zigzag in the case of the unsaturated. Then that means the fatty acid have two portion. One portion is hydrophilic, the other portion is hydrophobic. So it can act in both manner, as a water repelling and a water attracting compound. That's why it is called as amphipathic in nature. We learned that there are two types of fatty acids, saturated and unsaturated. And I told you that single bonds are here, one or more double bonds are here. Accordingly, the names are given as monoionic or diionic, etc. Then I told you the formula, how to understand the whole concept. Now, the more the number of carbons attached, that means the more longer the hydrocarbon chain is, higher will be the melting point of saturated fatty acid. And in the case of the unsaturated fatty acid, more the number of the double bonds, lesser will be the melting point. Then we learned that unsaturated fatty acids are generally liquid at room temperature, even in the winter, and then they are going to be solid even in the room temperature in the summer. And please remember, we talked about that there are two types of unsaturated fatty acid, essential and non-essential. Those which our body is able to synthesize daily, that means there is no need to have them from the outside as a supplementary food products and all. Such type of fatty acids are called as non-essential. Examples I told you. And if a fatty acid of a body, human body or animal body, is not able to synthesize, then it has to be taken daily in the regular diet. Such type of fatty acids are called as essential fatty acid. Examples I told you in the last class. Then I told you about that safola oil, MUFA and PUFA. So the whole thing is that these are found in the plant lipids and these are found in the animal lipids, or they are called as oil and these are called as fats. And after this we learned about the types of the lipids. There are three types of lipids possible. So we learned that lipids can be simple, compound, or derived. Simple lipids are those which carry only fatty acids. There is no other compound, no other compound than the fatty acids. But if there is something else also attached, for example, phosphate group or the oligosaccharide or the sulfate group or the protein part, then it would be called as a conjugate lipid or a compound lipid. And what are derived lipids? Those which are the product of breakdown or modification or reaction of the lipids, for example, cholesterol, vitamins which are lipid soluble, hormones. There are some steroidal hormones or like sex hormones and all. They all are made up of lipids. Then prostaglandin and terpenes. Then we learned that fats are nothing but the esters of fatty acids and glycerol. So when a glycerol, CH2OH, CHOH, CH2OH, when a glycerol reacts with only one fatty acid, it will give rise to a monoglyceride, and there is a loss of one molecule of water in this process. When at two places this reaction takes place, that means there are two fatty acids involved, then two molecules of water are lost and diglycerides are formed. Remember, these waters are also called as metabolic waters. So they are involved in the metabolic reactions elsewhere. So cells are able to meet their requirement of water by fatty acid oxidation or reactions or metabolism. Then if all the three hydroxyl group of glycerol are participating in the reaction with the fatty acids, or you can say ester bond formation, so in that case what will happen? This will be a triglyceride. And I told you in the last class it can be homo, that means all the R groups are similar, or they can be dissimilar. If all the R groups are similar.